Spaniard Ruben Xaus surprised everyone when he topped the timesheets in the Vallelunga World Superbike test this weekend. On board his sterile garden Ducati 999, Xaus just had one qualifying tyre to play with, but grasped the opportunity with both hands, and while the track temperature was lower early on the second day, he set a lap time that just none of his rivals could match. Reigning world champion Troy Bayliss was another man in top form. The Aussie finished the test in second position after working on electronic and suspension setup changes to suit the technical Vallelunga track. Fellow Australian Troy Corsa also had a good test. On board his Yamaha R1, Corsa worked on electronics and made a breakthrough with the anti-wheelie control to finish the test in third position. James Tozen was also another man working on electronics. Using the Pectal PI system for the second time, Tozen ended up the test in fourth position, having run at the front in practically every session. The Brit remains confident that they're making progress with the new electronics and is in high spirits for the next round of the championship in Brno. Italian Max Biaggi would have liked to have done better at his home track in front of his home fans, but the all-star Suzuki rider still finished the test in fifth position. Biaggi completed a massive 162 laps on the 2 days and didn't actually use a qualifying tyre. And looking further into the times, his pace on race tyres would have been good enough for top three. Yamaha man Noriyuki Haga looked strong on the first day, but took the seventh on day two after a problem with his number one bike. Haga made a change to his gearbox, but a technical problem prevented him from running it on day two, which saw him slip down the times. The next round of the World Superbike Championship takes place in Brno on the 22nd of July. With Tozen, Haga, Bayliss and Biaggi all well in contention, it could be a pivotal race in this year's championship.